Hello and good afternoon to all. Myself, Mrs. Sangeeta Karlekar, sports officer at this prestigious institution, Government Girls PG College, Ujjain, offers a warm and heartiest welcome to today's chief guest, a renowned personality in the field of physical education, Dr. Devashish Bagchi, Director and Head, Department of Physical Education and Sports Management, Parvati Bai Chaudhary College of Arts and Science, Shmadgaon, Goa. Today with us, two eminent personalities as a distinguished speaker for this webinar. Dr. K. Jyoti, Associate Professor, YMCA College of Physical Education, Nandanam, Chennai, and Dr. Kokab Azim, Professor, Department of Physical Education, King Fahad University of Petroleum and Minerals, Saudi Arabia. Is a chairperson of this webinar, Dr. Anita Manchandia, Principal, Government Girls PG College, Ujjain, is with us. All dignitaries, my colleagues, delegates, and all the participants, I welcome all of you being a convener of this webinar on behalf of the entire institution.
Thank you.
Today, we are celebrating 7th International Yoga Day with the theme, Be with Yoga, Be with Home. A very happy Yoga Day to all of you. In fact, it is a matter of great pride for our institution that on this very special day, we are organizing an international webinar on yoga with the topic, Yoga for Well-Being. I guarantee that this webinar will be productive and worth your precious time. प्राचीन काल से ही योग और स्वास्थ्य एक दूसरे के पूरक माने गए हैं। योग एक तकनीक है जिसमें अभ्यास के द्वारा स्वास्थ्य संवर्धन किया जा सकता है। योग तन को स्वस्थ रख मन को विकार युक्त बनाता है। कोरोना संक्रमण के दौरान पूरी दुनिया ने माना कि योगिक क्रियाएं हमें हर तरह के संक्रमण से बचाती है। योग शरीर के सभी आंतरिक भागों को सक्रिय कर ऊर्जा का प्रवाह बढ़ाता है। योग एक जीवन जीने की शैली है। शरीर को स्वस्थ एवं सेहतमंद बनाने का मार्ग है योग। योग और स्वास्थ्य, योगा फॉर वेलबींग, इसी विषय पर विचार मंथन हेतु आज का वेबिनार आयोजित है। नाउ आई वुड लाइक टू इनवाइट डॉक्टर नीता तपन, IQSE कोऑर्डिनेटर एंड प्रोफेसर ऑफ इकोनॉमिक्स टू गिव इंट्रोडक्टरी रिमार्क अबाउट दिस।
थैंक यू मैडम। इस पैंडेमिक ने दिखाया कि जिस तरह रातों रात हॉस्पिटल्स और अन्य हेल्थ इंफ्रास्ट्रक्चर नहीं खड़े किए जा सकते, उसी तरह इंटरनल इम्यूनिटी या चिंता में अचानक नहीं बिल्डअप हो सकते। प्राणवायु या ऑक्सीजन, चलती सांसें रुकती सांसें, चलता जीवन रुकता जीवन, पिछले कुछ समय में हमने ये सब भोगा और जाना। ये भी जाना कि लॉकडाउन्स में खेल बंद हो सकता है, हो सकते हैं, लेकिन चेतना पर ताले नहीं लग सकते। Realized that the best way to keep our mind and body healthy, we all need to adopt yoga as a lifestyle. में घटे वियोग ने योग की महिमा को वैश्विक स्तर पर और बढ़ा दिया। आज हमारा शरीर रोगग्रस्त हुआ या ना हो, मन हरेक का चिंता, भय और अवसाद से ग्रस्त हुआ। इसलिए बहुत जरूरी था कि ये अंतर्राष्ट्रीय योग दिवस पर इस तरह के वेबिनार्स का आयोजन जाए। शासन के किए गए आज के अनेक योग के साथ समझ में आया कि आज जब अंतर्राष्ट्रीय योग दिवस वर्ष गाष्ट पूरा विश्व इस दिन योगमय हो रहा है, सो आर इंश्योरेंस सेल एंड डिपार्टमेंट ऑफ फिजिकल एजुकेशन केम फोर्थ टू सेलिब्रेट International Yog Day with the theme Yoga Being. We heartily welcome our esteemed chief guest and the guest speakers and all the participants to this international webinar, which is being celebrated by our sports department, which is ever active in bringing our students on the ground for their physical activity, for their health and well-being. But since last lockdown, we have been conducting international and national webinars on the behalf of this department, bringing audience the benefits and advantages of staying at home and keeping healthy. I also again welcome all of you to this celebration of International Yoga Day, and now hand over the comparing to again webinar convener and our dynamic sports officer Geeta Karli. Over to you, madam. Thank you. Madam, please unmute your mic.
Thanks, Dr. Neeta Tappan, madam, for your valuable and brief introduction about this institution. Thanks a lot. Taking the program ahead, I am now going to invite Dr. Hemant Gehlot, sir, professor and head English department, Government Girls PG College, Ujjain, to deliver the welcome address. Over to you, sir.
Thank you. Thank you so much, Dr. Sangeeta Kalekar. Thanks to Dr. Neeta Tappan also for introducing the program. Good evening to our distinguished guests, Dr. Devashish Bagchi, Dr. Jyoti, and Dr. Azim. It's my proud privilege to welcome these three distinguished speakers of the international webinar on yoga organized by Government Girls PG College, Ujjain. The physical education department of the college, headed by Dr. Sangeeta Karlekar, is the main motto behind this webinar. As you must have seen the brochure, chief guest of the program today is our distinguished guest, Dr. Devashish Bagchi. On behalf of the IQAC Physical Education Department, Institute, and the participants, I welcome you, sir, to this August gathering.
Thank you.
Dr. Bagchi is the Director of Physical Education and also Head Department of Physical Education and Sports Management at Parvatibai Chowhule College of Arts and Science, Madgao, Goa. He was educated in Indore, that's very close to Ujjain, for the early schooling, and later completed his collegiate education from LNCP, now known as LNIPE, Gwalior. He was a meritorious student, successful teacher, and an ardent research scholar. Dr. Bagchi is known world over for his novel ideas and research findings in the field of physical education. He has organized and participated in various national and international seminars and conferences. He bears witness to example is better than precept. वो कहते हैं ना करके दिखाना ज्यादा जरूरी होता है बजाय किसी को कुछ करने के लिए कहना. और डॉक्टर बागची जो कि अपने आप में एक एस्टेब्लिश्ड फर्स्ट क्लास क्रिकेटर रहे हैं, जिन्होंने गोवा रिप्रेजेंट किया रणजी में और एस पिल्लई ट्रॉफी में. एज ए स्टूडेंट आल्सो ही हैड रिप्रेजेंटेड इंदौर एंड जिवाजी यूनिवर्सिटी इन वेस्ट जोन, एंड ही आल्सो कैप्टन जिवाजी यूनिवर्सिटी इन जयपुर इन 1989. I welcome you, sir, to this international webinar, and I'm sure your ideas and your pragmatic discussions will be beneficial to all of us here on the receiving end. Our second guest of honor is Dr. K. Jyoti. She is an associate professor at YMCA College of Physical Education at Nandanam, Chennai. Another brilliant alumni of LNCP who specializes in kinesiology and biomechanics, along with exercise physiology and yoga. A dynamic teacher and a versatile researcher who has more than 66 research papers to her credit, along with almost 24 PhDs. Her academic achievements include about 200 lectures at national and international platforms, 8 books, 6 awards and patents. A huge personal contribution to the field of physical education, madam. We are honored to have such a distinguished guest like Dr. Jyoti amongst us as our guest speaker for this scintillating international seminar. Finally, this is an international seminar, and the two dignitaries I talked to about also hold the portfolios that are known and recognized internationally. We have the third guest speaker from Saudi Arabia. With immense pleasure, I now welcome our guest speaker from Saudi Arabia, Dr. Kokab Azim, who is president of International Federation of Fitness, Health, Physical Education, and Iron Games. Dr. Azim also holds vice presidentship of World Strength Lifting Federation. Though he's connected to us from Saudi Arabia, but he hails from Hyderabad, where he did his schooling and later collegiate education from Usmania University, Hyderabad. It's indeed a great privilege to welcome the gold medalist at the International Strength Lifting Competition in Bahrain in the year 2015. He is associated with Sports Federation internationally and actively participated in the conferences where he was felicitated for best paper presentation. His research work focuses on strength training, physical activity, aerobics, and health. He has published more than 90 research papers in international journals and also served as member of editorial boards of the many international journals. Another feather in his cap is being scientific advisor to Federation for Global Community Health USA. He is also a visiting professor in UNY Indonesia for the current session 2020-21. We welcome once again all the august distinguished guests to this august and adorable international webinar held on the International Day of Yoga. Once again, welcome to all the three distinguished speakers. Thank you very much for the opportunity. Over to Dr. Sangeeta Kallekar.
Thanks, sir. You gave a remarkable welcome speech. I am very thankful to you. Now I feel extremely honored to introduce today's guest of honor, a keynote speaker, Honorable Dr. Devashish Bagchi, Director and Head Education and Sports Management, Parvati Bai Chogule College of Arts and Science, Madgaon, Goa, a well-known name in the field of physical education and a wonderful personality, can't describe in words. It is such a privilege to have him with us on this virtual platform as a guest of honor. Here I am giving a brief introduction of such a great personality. Dr. Devashish Bagchi has been working as a director and head, Department of Physical Education and Sports Management, Parvati Bai Chogule College of Arts and Science, Madgaon, Goa, since 1991. He has done his initial schooling at prestigious St. Paul's School, Indore, Madhya Pradesh. He joined Lakshmibai National College of Physical Education in 1984 and completed the degrees BP, MP, MPhil and PhDs and with meritorious academic records. He is well-known academician and has been on the Board of Studies, Advisory Board of Academic Organization, an examiner and paper setter. He is also a resource person for last 12 years in the field of information communication technology and sports management for UGC, HRDC of LNIP and other universities. He is a regular resource person for national and international webinars organized throughout the country. He is consultant on Institute in India. He has participated in number of paper presentation and book reviews contest. He has successfully organized international conferences in sports medicine, exercise science at Goa in 2003 and has been a part of the main organizing committee in 1996 and 2008. He has presented 24 research papers at national and international conference. He has been a first-class cricketer, having represented Goa in Ranji Trophy and Subbaiah Pillai Trophy. He has played opposite alongside almost of all top cricketers in India during BCCI domestic limited overs, matches and other prestigious tournament. He also had an honor of playing in finals against legendary Sachin Tendulkar in All India Single Wicket Cricket Championship in 1996. Currently, he is representing Goa in South Zone Veterans Cricket Tournament organized by South Zone Veterans Cricket Association. He was also the part of Indian Diggers Cricket Team at Hong Kong Noble Super Sixes in 2009. He follows a regular fitness program on daily basis, takes up the fitness challenging and plays multiple sports and any given opportunities. इनकी उपलब्धियों की फहरिस्त बहुत लंबी है जिसका उल्लेख करना यहाँ संभव नहीं है क्योंकि हमारे पास समय कम है. We are pleased to have you, sir, here. Please come and share your thoughts with us. Dr. Devashish Bakshi, over to you, sir.
Yeah, good afternoon. Namaskar, सभी को. सबसे पहले तो I would like to congratulate Government Girls Postgraduate College, Ujjain, for hosting an international academic session on such an auspicious area of well-being, health, wellness, as well as very, very relevant, as Dr. Jyoti said, in current time, especially this pandemic. I'm sorry, Dr. Tapan said that pandemic has made us realize what can be done within the limited resources. Well, I remember I was following the session of 69th session of the United Nations General Assembly, wherein Honorable Prime Minister Shri Modi ji put forth a draft of yoga as a world concept, a gift of India's ancient tradition and India's very different way of looking at health, very, very right way, deeper way to the world community. So it was in 2014 when the UN General Assembly made a very historical move, wherein 177 countries, I mean, that's a record in itself, resolved to celebrate 21st June as an International Yoga Day. And another record was, if I'm not wrong, I stand corrected, that there was an exceptional thing happened, that no voting took place. So the world understands the value of ancient thinking and deep philosophy. Today, we are all celebrating, the world is celebrating International Yoga Day, and I'm very pleased to tell you that the number of countries from initial 177, today it stands almost 200 countries, which are celebrating in whatever their ways. So the value of yoga is getting grounds higher and higher. I wish you a very, very happy International Yoga Day. And we all know that when a day is reserved for such an important occasion, it kickstarts a new journey, or it reminds people. So one day of 365 starts a new channel in everybody's life. And Government Girls Degree Postgraduate College has kicked off. The Indian government is also committed to create a perfect balance between education and wellness. I'll come to that later on in my address. But prior to that, I'm extremely grateful to Dr. Anita Manjandia, principal of this prestigious college, Professor Neeta Tappan, a member of a coordinator of Internal Quality Assurance Cell of the Institute. I'm also a member of IQAC since its inception, and we constantly strive to bring in innovations and best practices in teaching, learning, and evaluation, improving departmental activities, giving our colleges autonomous, and stands pretty tall in NAC rankings. But that's one aspect of it. We are constantly introspecting ourselves, learning from each other, benchmarking with other institutes. So I congratulate the IQAC, which is a very important component of any institution. I especially thank my friend, my classmate, and a fellow Malvi. I mean, we are from Malwa, born and brought up in Indore, so Ujjain is one of the epicenter of Malwa. Again, just opening the talk, I'll come back to that later on. And I'm pretty thankful to you all for giving me this honor. Well, as I was telling, the educational bodies are thinking constantly about striking a perfect balance between all sorts of academic loads, learning, gaining more and more information, relevant information, and at the same time, keeping ourselves healthy, because there is a concept, who is healthy? And I will come to a small mention of Mukul Kanitkarji. But prior to that, when we were studying in LNCP Gwalior, I was sharing this thing with my classmates on our WhatsApp group. What exactly, I was reminding them, if they have physical health can be defined, or rather positive health should be defined more on not just only physiological, anatomical, or what we call it, physical health, but also the mental health, social health, emotional health, and spiritual health. Now, when we say this word spiritual health, these are all beyond geographical boundaries. It is beyond time. It's beyond any religion. Yoga is also beyond any geographical boundaries. It is not just limited to one small country. It belongs to everybody on this earth. It never had time. It was born ages before, and it will carry on for the ages to come. Similarly, there is no religious angle to it. It's a technique, as Dr. Sangeeta Karlekar very rightly put up. It's a way of life. The right way of living. There are other forms of art in the world over, which are equally deep and equally beneficial, whatever they are. But they're all beneficial, and we should adopt them. And what could be a better day to start your journey? That's today. Mukul Kanitkar, who is a national organizing secretary of Bharatiya Shikshan Mandal, he's a prolific speaker on Gita and on the teaching and learning or teaching of Swami Vivekananda. He says that ki agar manushya ka swasth acha hoga, jab wo swasth ki baat karte hain to wo शारीरिक स्वास्थ्य की बात करते हैं, मानसिक स्वास्थ्य की बात करते हैं, सामाजिक स्वास्थ्य की बात करते हैं, सैद्धांतिक स्वास्थ्य की बात करते हैं, विचारों के स्वास्थ्य की बात करते हैं, यानी कि विजडम, ह्यूमैनिटी. एंड ही पुट्स फोर्थ स्वामी विवेकानंद टीचिंग, यू नो द फेमस एड्रेस इन एट शिकागो, इफ यू ऑल रिमेंबर दैट, इफ आई एम हेल्दी, माई family would be healthy. I mean, definitely I'll promote good things among my fellow peer, if my family is healthy, that society where we are living in, because we have social health, positive social health, and if you climb over the ladders, society makes us a area where these multiple societies live. I mean, that spread, there will be healthy social health spreading over there, and then so on, country and so on, nations and so on, the world, the global health. So these are the tools. These are the tools, ancient tools, and people have done research beyond imagination to create a concept. I mean, we should bow down to those thinkings, those philosophers who had literally no, their imagination was magnificent. Well, jaisa ki introduction mein Gehlot saab ne bola, he had put it up in a very wonderful words. I really admire people who say multiple things and a paragraph into a sentence, and that's the beauty of the language. I'm born and brought up in Indore. Main Indore mein paida hua 1966 mein. Wahi pala bada. Schooling thi, Holkar Science College mein mathematics mein admission liya. Aur uske baad mere pitaji, unka bhi naam Vivekanand hai, professor the botany ke. वो ग्वालियर कॉलेज में जो पहले विक्टोरिया कॉलेज था वो एमएलबी कॉलेज के नाम से इट वाज अ साइंस आल्सो वेरी बिग पर्सनालिटीज हैव स्टडीड देयर ह्यूज पर्सनालिटीज लाइक अटल बिहारी वाजपेयी एंड अदर्स हु हैव पास्ड आउट ऑफ सच इंस्टीट्यूट ही वाज टीचिंग देयर एंड इट वाज देन व्हेन दिस एलएनसीपी लक्ष्मीबाई नेशनल कॉलेज ऑफ फिजिकल एजुकेशन व्हिच इज अ मैग्निफिसेंट कैंपस वन ऑफ द सीट्स ऑफ लर्निंग इन दिस फील्ड ऑफ एजुकेशन फिजिकल एजुकेशन स्पोर्ट्स साइंसेस. So he said, you go there, do something for this subject. Fine. I think you should move there. And I'm thankful to him. It was a very enterprising area from pure mathematics and coming down instead of joining. There was an option of joining Sri Govindaram Seksaria Institute of Technology and Science, SGSITS, which is also a very, very prominent institute in engineering. Counseling was just going on. I mean, sort of counseling those days was not very easy. The percentage was important and he used to walk in. CET started later on. So I joined this college and I found that this subject has got huge scope. It has got a lot of meaning for people. I mean, performance in sports, analysis of sports, that's what Jyoti and me come from. Both of us are also classmates. Three of us are classmates here. So there is, you can sense a little bias by the convener of this international conference calling all our classmates. Jyoti and me both have done biomechanics and kinesiology, one of the few first batches of MPhil. The subject had no values. I mean, people didn't understand. As today, chiropractic is also not being given that value. I mean, time will come and people will look forward to such wonderful therapeutic means. Yoga therapy is a wonderful concept. Natural therapy is a very wonderful concept. So, yoga not only as a form of healthy inner life, inner body, core body, but it's also is a wonderful way of healing yourself of various ailments, I mean, multiple ailments. How far? That's the expert will talk about that. Perhaps more sessions at girls' postgraduate college, Ujjain, would bring in more theoretical and practical aspects of yoga. I mean, it's again, this day is a starter. I mean, it's the kicking off day. There must be number of sessions taken by Sangeeta in past, and I'm sure she must have done what not that institution requires. I mean, every child, whether 1 year old or 90 year old, I put it up that way, or age is no number, basically anyone. So we at college is not supposed to be only focusing on university events, intercollegiate events, and a couple of annual events like athletic meet or sports days or International Women's Day, that is 8th March, you know, perhaps. But we have to also see that you are a torch bearer of the health of your community. And that community involves not only students, it involves the faculties, it involves the non-teaching members, it involves the area around the community, I mean your college. It's a community outreach program. So you are responsible for them and you must take the onus on yourself to spread wellness, happiness, education, wisdom, humanity, perhaps. So I'm born and brought up in Indore, so I'm very, Ujjain is very close to my heart. I must have visited Ujjain on hundreds of different occasions, religious or cricket. I played a lot of cricket matches in Ujjain. I have my very good friend Mukesh Sahni, who belongs to Ujjain, currently a very, very well-known cricket player in MP, settled down in MP Indore. He used to come from Ujjain, and we used to come to his house. Very simple-minded people, religious people, a good city, full of traditions, culture, and very relevant to yoga also, because as per the yogic philosophy, Shiva is considered as an Adi Yogi, the first practitioner of yoga. And also he is considered as Adi Guru, the first teacher of yoga. And Ujjain is a seat of one of the most prominent Jyotirlinga, Mahankaleshwar Mandir. And that's why there is a huge connection of Ujjain with yoga. A very rich center, epicenter of the Malwa history, Central Indian history in the past. It has a very rich history. And it is religious epicenter of pilgrimage for Hindu culture. So Indore Ujjain, as Professor Gehlot has rightly put up, is just 66 kilometers away. And as the development, urban development, rural development is taking place, perhaps one day these two cities may meet somewhere, halfway, somewhere or somewhere. Well, keeping that tradition on, I suppose the Department of Physical Education of Girls Postgraduate College, Ujjain, must set up a cell and have continuous research. And we all know that new education policy, the government has been putting a lot of emphasis on making health education, yoga, and physical education as an integral part of the curriculum, and trying to call it a curricular subject rather than the so-called extracurricular or other aspects of co-curricular. They're merging. Everything is very, 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 very important for the young generation. I do extend my greetings to my classmate and friend, Dr. Jyoti, a very meritorious student, very hardworking scholar of her time, and still she's very, very keen on finding out the deeper science, senses of physiology, exercise physiology. She has a keen interest in yoga, and she's been into teaching since ages. I had met her in an international conference which was organized by the first University of Physical Education, Tamil Nadu, at Chennai. I'm very happy to see her. She's very knowledgeable. She's always focused. She will be a good resource person for days to come for Government Girls Postgraduate College on this topic. You can create an online link between people who are deeply knowledgeable about the yoga science, neurology of yoga, the yoga therapy, and the goodness of yoga. I am very happy to see a new friend of mine. I extend my greetings to Azim Saab, who comes from King's Fahd University in Saudi Arabia. We have a classmate, Biju Matthew, who is teaching in Jeddah. So you can meet him. He's also a very knowledgeable man, very talented sportsperson. I'm sure these two resource persons are being picked up very, very rightly by Dr. Sangeeta Supekar Karlekar. And I'm sure those who are viewing this live stream, students especially, would get more keen to know about practicing yoga, that is one way, and then learning yoga to teach others, that's another way. I was seeing that the Government of India has launched an app to rightly put up the science to the world. I mean, they're trying to create a syllabi, trying to create a way to actually follow the right way of yoga, because people innovate. So nothing is wrong innovation, but sometimes they innovate into a different way. So we have seen various forms of yoga, Western country as well as in India. Some of them are a little distorted, and it's not that it is going to. But wrong practices would waste people's time. They may harm themselves. The right science of eating, sleeping, and practicing, the exact balance between load, rest, and recovery, the exact knowledge about what to eat, what not to eat, and so on and so forth. So therefore, it is very important that yoga should have its own entity, its own place in the Indian education system, and it should put in knowledge to young people who can follow their own path. I was listening to a talk on Lok Sabha TV, perhaps not very popular channel, but it really covers a couple of areas which are not so popular on the other channels. And professors of Yoga University in UP, having spent 40 years of research and learning on yoga, they're standing masters in that subject. Then another person I was listening to a couple of days back was from Mata Vaishno Devi Institute of Yoga, which works on yoga neurology, the neurology of yoga. And also, while working for NCERT on a committee for writing a working paper on new education policy and putting forth the right of physical education to be included in the best possible way and create manpower, human resource, specifically to teach in schools and in higher education. I learned from this great knowledgeable people that to practice yoga, they were saying that let's not go into the deep science of yoga, but for a common man, for a rickshaw driver, for a shopkeeper, for a teacher, somebody who is into some other form of work in society, instead of going deeper into the science of yoga, right exercises of yoga in a balanced manner should be taught to them, so that they should not be confused in the science, which is very deep. Yoga science is very deep. But yes, those who are going to teach yoga, the teachers at school level, high school level, high secondary level, college, university level, and for the common society, open, must have the deepest knowledge of the subject, so that they, what they render to others, should be proper, scientific, and logical. Well, as I told you, like Dr. Tapin, I also am part of the IQAC, and we constantly think about new ways of teaching, learning, evaluation, departmental administration, student-teacher relationships, campus life of children. And we do benchmarking. So before I finally say goodbye and open the stage for the right knowledgeable people from the field of yoga, Dr. Jyoti and Dr. Azim, I extend my humble request to the Institute of Government Girls Postgraduate College Principal, Dr. Anita Manchandia, professors, associate professors, assistant professors, to do visit my institute, Chogle College. It's the oldest institute in Goa, 1962, the first institute in Goa. Stand tall for its practices. It's a role model for many institutes around. And we do benchmarking with each other. I mean, I travel once in a or twice in a year, academic year, or in my holidays times to good institutes to go and learn what they are doing and what I can learn from them and bring into my college. And as a courtesy, reciprocal, I invite them to come and check what we are doing. So this is how the goodness spreads, the good practices spread. So I invite you all, then Goa is a wonderful place, but put up a word here, which is not a topic seminar, but Goa, what we here from tourist point of view, and Goa where we live are two different ends of pole. It's a very, very simple, very good people stay here. Yes, there is some fanfare on some of the beaches, but Goa is just not five or six beaches. There are 128 odd beaches here, and there are couple of more than 70% of beaches are only inhabited or visited by the locals. few beaches. Of course, tourism is a industry in Goa, and the economy of the state has a lot of relevance to that particular tourism. But also it brings in good and bad practices. So it's limited, very limited. 20-25% might be lesser than that. Goa is beautiful. It has 1,000 other things to see rather than a couple of places that are popular. And my students, I've been teaching since 31 years. It's a pleasure. Every day is a pleasure to work for Institute. It's such a simple and such a convenient atmosphere, such an autonomous atmosphere that not only the college is autonomous, but the departments are also autonomous. I mean, there is no terminology as such in the Indian education, higher education yet. And a department can have its own autonomy, but we practice that. And we are totally responsible, committed to the section of student and other college faculties. And we keep constantly learning from each other. Today, Sangeeta's international webinar is a kind of a boost to me. I don't have expertise in yoga, but I definitely won't read something and say something until unless I know it thoroughly core to core. But yes, there is a full department of yoga which works in my institute. And there are a couple of my colleagues who are coming from various subjects. And one of my watchmen, college watchmen, is chief security officer who comes from the Indian Army background. He's our chairman of that school of yoga, and we keep doing something or the other. Today morning was packed with a lot of things. We were doing multiple sessions from multiple beautiful scenic places in Goa. So somebody was on hilltop, somebody was in the old temple ruins, and somebody was, we were doing that, and we were connected through various sources. I sincerely thank Dr. Anita Manjandia, the IQSS unit of college, and Sangeeta Khalekar, the head of the Department of Physical Education, for giving me this great honor to be something in this part of her attempt. And I assure you that as a department, we'll be connected, and whatever we do here, I will always mail that to my friend and colleague Sangeeta, and expect her to share some goodness that she is doing and we are failing to do so. Thank you once again, and I wish a very, very, hope very good sessions will happen and you will be enriched soon after that. Thank you. Namaskar.
Thanks. Thanks, Dr. Devashish Bakshi. Thanks for your outstanding speech. Thank you very much for sharing your time and valuable experience with us. Many, many thanks for addressing us. Now, without any further delay, I would like to call Dr. Nancy Chauhan, Madam, Professor and Head of the Department Economics, Government Girls PG College, Ujjain, to introduce our distinguished speaker, Dr. K. Jyoti. Over to you, Madam.
Thanks, Sangeeta, Madam. Good afternoon and very warm greetings on the 7th International Yoga Day to all of you. To make this occasion even more meaningful and significant today, the Department of Physical Education and Internal Quality Assurance Cell of Government Girls PG College, Ujjain, Madhya Pradesh, are organizing a one-day international webinar on yoga for well-being. In this webinar, we have two resource persons with us. Our first resource person is Dr. K. Jyoti, who is going to enlighten us on yoga, the science for inner peace. It is my great privilege and honor to introduce her to all of you. Dr. K. Jyoti is an associate professor at YMCA College of Physical Education, Nandanam, Chennai, and has an experience of more than 30 years. She is a MSc in Yoga and Naturopathy from MS University and a PhD in exercise physiology from Annamalai University, Chidambaram. Dr. Jyothi's area of specialization are yoga, kinesiology, biomechanics, physical education, and health sciences. She has published 66 papers in journals and has 41 international journals in her name with an impact factor of more than 6.4. 17 PhDs and 97 MPhils have been awarded under her guidance. Dr. Jyothi has successfully delivered 188 lectures at national and international level and has written 8 books on various topics. She has also received 6 patents and has outstanding contributions in the field of aerobics and yoga. We are extremely happy and honored to have such an expert of yoga like her with us today. Now, with great respect, I would like to invite Professor Jyothi to share her views on yoga, the science for inner peace. Jyothi Madam.
Thank you so much. We went on with the inaugural function and I think people are there to hear. And on the very outside, I would like to thank the college for having taken such a beautiful day as one of the auspicious day. And I would also like to thank the principal, the IQAC coordinator, in particular, Dr. Sangeeta Karlekar, for taking such a big effort in bringing out this as an international webinar. And through the virtual mode, I'm able to reach people, you know, during this pandemic situation. It's one of the innovative and best way. Now, let me start sharing my PowerPoint on the topic that she has given to me. I hope the slides are visible.
Yes, ma'am, visible.
Thank you so much. So, Sangeeta Karlekar madam has asked me to present on the topic Yoga, the Science for Peace. Basically, the word yoga itself is a term which denotes peace only. So let me, on my very outset, congratulate you on this auspicious day. That is, let me wish you all a very happy International Day. So now we will see that the pandemic situation has been created. Now, what is this that we may think? So basically, it is the influenza virus which comes into the human being, and we don't have immunity to face that particular virus. Thus, there is a loss of people. It sweeps the whole population and serious illness is end up. So in this situation, you know, the world WHO has declared this as pandemic issue, and we all are now going through. Now, when we look into that every day, we look for the breaking news. So like what has happened in the first wave, we were looking into few deaths and some informations were always given. But then in the second wave, you know, we find that our known people, our relatives, our friends, and then somebody who is near and dear to us, we have lost so many people. So third wave, and of course, is I wish it doesn't affect people. So children going to the school are being affected, people going to the university, going to factory, and the army people looking into it. Everything is being affected and we are losing our mental peace. Now the family which goes today with the macro family to micro family, if people who are under having the macro family with their grandparents or with their parents or something of that, you know, this COVID has drastically affected them because the mutation, you all know other things of what has been happening. So when you look into the health aspect of an individual, we just say that I don't have cold, I don't have fever, and absolutely fine. It doesn't choose to be. So you need to be mentally, physically first, you know, per square centimeter, the number of hair in your head particularly speaks about your health. The moment you lose hair, you know, we become very conscious. So data has also revealed that losing hair definitely speaks about your, particularly your health, and also it affects your psychologically, it depresses you. So hair is one thing which reflects the complete physical aspect of your body, your ability, your eyes, your skin, everything is one aspect of that. Now, when you get into the mental, how you react? If there is a COVID patient which has been affected in your family member, yeah, what is your reaction? Do you get panicked? Do you shout? Do you scream? What is that? How do you handle the situation? And that speaks about your mental ability. And how well you are addressed by your society, and how can you link yourself spiritually? So this is what is the actual meaning which speaks about. And spiritually, you can connect yourself through yogic practice, and it will always give you the mental peace. Now, you all know, I know that you all know the meaning of yoga, but then still what it takes you is the, it takes you to the union. Yeah. So attains and merges to the individual human consciousness with their cosmic consciousness. This is what we want. If I say that yoga chitta vritti nirodha, that is controlling the wandering mind. So if I keep my eyes open, even if a rat or a cat which passes, you know, I'll just look at that thing. So though it is not relevant to me, but then I look. So yoga makes you to bring your body, mind and spirit, which gets integrated. And today we are celebrating this Yoga Day globally. And WHO has declared this, and not only India, but all over the world. If you see, India has started adopting yoga only only through this International Yoga Day. Otherwise, you know, it was only the Western countries who were following yoga as a part of their curriculum. And today, if you see, there are more than 176 to 200 institutions which has adopted yoga as a part of their curriculum. And we still find it difficult. Of course, the central government is the pioneer to take over this. And I remember of having done, and I did have my yoga teacher while I was graduating my 12th standard during my school days from Kendra Vidyalaya. And still in South India, we do find it difficult to identify yoga as a part of their, you know, daily routine. But still, we are working on it. Right. So some of the advantages, we, when you look, you know, so it improves the brain function. Because of the COVID, what happens is the cells become dead and the oxygen supply to the brain goes off. And we say punji, kala punji, yellow punji, yes, something we start talking about. But it is not
doctor,
so.
Once doctor, your slides are not changing. Sorry to disturb you. Your slides are not changing. Thank you.
I've been asking that.
Yeah. Your slides are not changing. Actually, okay. We are in the first slide, please. Sorry to disturb.
Yeah. Okay. Again,
you have to share your exit and share your PowerPoint again.
No,
we are not. It's coming now. Yeah, it's okay. Now we are in the, I believe, on the ninth
yeah,
slide.
Thank you so much.
We are in the ninth slide.
Yeah, fine. Right now, I've changed.
No, not change. You changed to 10 or 8.
Yes.
Still,
yes.
We are on 9.
No.
9 only.
No.
9.
Why is not getting, sir? Can somebody assist me?
Ma'am, please exit the presentation mode.
हाँ हो गया कर रही हूँ अरे यार
you have to keep your PowerPoint open on your laptop
हाँ जी open है ये वाला नया system I have ये sorry
actually you have to keep your PowerPoint open don't open minimize it don't minimize it
okay ये क्या हो रहा
then share it
Yeah. नहीं नहीं ये एग्जिट ही नहीं हुआ ओपन में है नाउ आई एम गेटिंग ऑन टू इट शेयरिंग शेयर वीडियो ऑडियो विंडो सर हो रहा है नाइन्थ में हूँ अभी मैं कर रही हूँ अभी मैं उसको नेक्स्ट में करती हूँ देखिए अभी
नाउ इट्स चेंजिंग यस
ठीक है मैं मोड में ला रही हूँ अभी अभी मैं दूसरा बदल रही हूँ देखिए बदल रहा
है नाउ इट इज ऑन द सम ऑफ द एडवांटेजेस ऑफ योगा आर एज फॉलोस महापराया
नहीं मैंने दूसरा बदल दिया है अभी नहीं दिखाई दे रहा ठीक है फिर मैं एग्जिट में ही बात करती हूँ ये कुछ नहीं हो रहा है आई डोंट नो व्हाट
ओके ओके प्लीज
शरण
एक्सक्यूज मी मैम प्रेजेंटेशन मोड जो है वो लीव कर दीजिए आप सिंपल आपको आगे कंटिन्यू कर लीजिए
क्या करूं
हेलो ज्योति मैडम
हाँ जी
मैडम जो स्लाइड मोड आपने लगाया ना वो छोड़ दीजिए आप और सिंपल आप कंटिन्यू कर लीजिए नेक्स्ट
हाँ वैसे ही कंटिन्यू कर लेती हूँ मैं ठीक है सर
F5 में मत करिए F5 में मत जाइए जस्ट हाँ ये हो रहा है ये ठीक है
हो रहा है लेकिन F5 जाने से नहीं हो रहा है ठीक है सर
नहीं हो रहा
एक और बार ट्राई कर लेती हूँ मैं एक और बार लास्ट टाइम
नहीं हो रहा मैडम उसमें F5 में नहीं हो रहा वो मैं भी चेक किया नहीं हो रहा
आप में भी नहीं हो रहा नॉट फ्रेंडली
शेयरिंग द स्क्रीन इज नॉट फ्रेंडली
नॉट फ्रेंडली ओके सर दिस इज दिस स्ट्रीम यार्ड इज लिटिल डिस्टर्बिंग एनी हाउ थैंक यू सो मच We'll go with it, right? So, नहीं हो रहा शाह।
इसको बड़ा कर।
हाँ बड़ा कर।
बार अंते। स्क्रॉल करना, मैन स्क्रॉल करना है।
सर अभी थोड़ा सा बड़ा हो गया।
हाँ, जरा छोटा करें तो ऊपर के वर्डिंग्स भी दिखेंगे।
ठीक है मैं ऐसे ही कर लेती हूँ ओके सो व्हाट हैपेंस इज दिस लीड्स टू द येलो फंगस एंड द ब्लैक फंगस दैट वी कीप ऑन स्पीकिंग एक्चुअली इट इज नॉट सो सो व्हाट हैपेंस इज द ब्लड सप्लाई टू द ब्रेन डजंट गो सो इफ यू गो विद द योगिक प्रैक्टिस यू कैन डेफिनेटली इंप्रूव योर ब्रेन फंक्शन एंड इट लोवर्स योर स्ट्रेस लेवल दैट वी ऑल नो एंड ऑल्टर्स द जीन नाउ R&D आई मीन The gene which is affecting, you know, the corona which is coming into our body. So, because of the yogic practice, you can alter the gene expression. If some your parents have had diabetes or hypertension or cancer or something of that, through yogic practice, you can change and break that particular gene. That is how you can go with it. And it increases the flexibility. Flexibility is something which you can keep your youth, you can keep your spine erect, you can find the blood supply to the brain is there, and you can keep yourself active throughout the day. Right. It decreases your blood pressure, lungs and all that it goes. I'll just shift to the next one. And basically when you perform yoga, you know, what happens is the first stage, you try to touch upon your physical body. In the second stage of practicing yoga, you will touch upon the union of body and the mind. In the third stage, as you keep practicing, you know, you develop the intellectual ability. And in the fourth stage, you become the perfect person. So when you see the science, people may think that yoga is something which need to be practiced only by in the Himalayas or in the caves or by the saints. It's not so, but it can be performed by everybody and everybody can do it. There are two extreme things which happens. Basically, they say that it is difficult. Some say it is too simple. But one have to study the truth about it. Yeah. So when you look into the yogic science, you know, how you can have a mental peace. So we basically keep aspiring. A person who's having a small car would aspire for a bigger one. If one, then they'll go for two. So this is the way they try to improve their material pleasure. But material pleasure cannot give true satisfaction or joy. So there's no limit for our expectation, our desires, and try to keep doing your duty without any expectation. This is the actual life of yoga. This is how we need to go, and our life will prosper like highways and the happiness. So when you look into the you know, the union, what it takes place is just when we compare, you know, the controller of the universe is called as Atma, and the joint Atma with Paramatma is something. So just take, if Paramatma is ocean and Atma the one drop of water, so I may take red color or blue color water and just dip it in the ocean, this color will vanish. We will not come to know where have you dropped. So it's our case. When the Atma is united with Paramatma, we lose our identity. And this is what is the aim of yoga. I, me, myself. Okay, this goes off. Basically, yoga is a science of personality. Don't think that it is, you're just wasting your time by performing it. It is basically the physical condition. It improves your complete alignment of the body, your posture of your body, your appearance, your mental control, how you need to act upon, your emotional balance, right? If you are in stress or in distress, or you're with happy or joy, you can control your emotion completely, and ultimately it leads to intellectual development. So when you perform yoga, you touch upon the chakras of the body. So basically, when you look at it, you know, like just like the center of gravity in our body, which is an imaginary point, in the same manner you have the chakra points in your spine, which is again an imaginary point, right? And in at the back you have the peripheral nerves which are there. So when you try to activate, that is why teachers in the school, you know, they'll bang the table and say, all of you sit straight. Sitting straight, you know, basically is one of the methods that you can activate even your chakras. Even by performing yogas, you can activate your chakras. So if you would have seen, you know, in the military hospital, I have seen, as you enter in a few hospitals that I have come across, Patanjali statue is there, and it is just ruled by the snake. Yeah, the snake winds up the statue, and then a sarp ka head is exhibited. It shows that every doctor need to have the power like a snake, right? So doctors need to touch upon the patient and identify what is the problem that is existing over there. So somebody is getting disturbed. Can I mute them? Kindly mute them. Sir. Yeah. So this has to go on. And when you start with the Kundalini Shakti, when it evokes, you know, it tries to touch upon your power. So just like a snake, the snake can feel due to sensation. So the amount of sensation, the vibration, you know, the snake becomes alert. In the same manner, a yogi, we will call every one of us to be as yogi. Why? Because we attain the power like a snake, and the moment what we need to do, you know, we get that power. So just like doctors, they should be so vigilant to look at the patient, the symptoms you're able to do. That is why this symbol of doctor is being kept for those people. So when you try to do this, you evoke the Kundalini Shakti. Now, when you see the nadis, there are thousands of nadis in our body. So just like this center points I've said about the center of gravity, yeah, you could see the left side, the right side, the inguinal nadi, pigna nadi, and the sukshma nadi. So you get the balance of the nadis. So by doing yogasana, you just activate the nadis, and all your blocks are actually being cleansed. So everything exists in the world as a form of atom. Yeah, that's it. So even the solid as energy and not as a solid mass. So if this energy increases in your body, what happens is it leads to hypertension. So are the children at home, you know, you make them to sit for longer, their energy, actually they are compared with the steam engine, and their ability to play for whole day is so much that we are trying to block them and keep them at home. So if the energy is too much, obviously they start practicing, and it becomes, they implement it in the different format. And just like this, you know, when you try to compare the highways, right? So it is can be compared with your body. As long as the traffic is fine on the highways, you are absolutely fine. The moment you find that there is some block in the body or in the highway, similarly, the unhappiness starts attracting an individual. So yoga helps you to unblock the highways or nadis and move energy, making the city more happy. So it helps you to still the mind and brings bliss. That is the consciousness. You become conscious what you're speaking, where you're speaking, what you're eating, how you need to address yourself. All these, you know, your mind will give you alertness. The moment we are eating, you know, we get the conscious, inner conscious, which speaks, stop eating, you are eating too much. So anything extra sleeping, extra talk, extra watching TV, extra listening to music, extra with the cell phone, anything extra would end up with a disaster. So yoga will definitely help you to get that still mind, the happiness, the mental peace can be attained through that. Now, through yoga, you can see that the happy hormones like serotonin, dopamine, and the oxytocin, it is secreted, all right? So this stays in your body for some time and you feel so pleasurable, and it definitely gives you a mental peace. It eases your stress, supplies more oxygen to the working muscles, or as you go with the pranayama, breathe in and breathe out. So many researchers have spoken very high about the effects of yogic practice in various systems and the health outcomes of the human being. And today, corona has become one of the head topic where every time we see somebody performing, you know, this is good. And if you see the research, you know, it is spoken very high about yogic practice. You can reduce pressure, you can reduce the stress, manage the pain. Yeah. So the pain is something, even after a very big accident, you know, there was one particular person and with too few people, they could manage the pain, all those who performed yogasana, and the recovery was also very faster. So you can also reduce the disease symptoms like small tunnel carpals. You know, you can see the little fingers paining, the osteoarthritis, the cancer, the symptoms of the cancer, the diabetes, the cervical cancer. All these are something which is now becoming very common in the human being. And we find that in every almost 10 family, there is one cancer patient which is suffering with cancer, different kind of cancer. So we need to encourage people even at the old age to perform yogasana so that they can overcome with all these things. And the other benefit that we see with the system, the heart and the respiratory, cardiorespiratory, the musculoskeletal, yeah, the muscle and the bone, the psycho biological, the way you sleep, the way you digest the food, are you getting affected? So if somebody is disturbing you, are you getting disturbed? If the media is trying to catch you, are you getting disturbed? So just don't mind, right? That is where we try to. Otherwise, you know, it affects the complete system and one leads to depression, and one have to go for medication then. So doing yoga can also help you to increase your metabolic rate, and you can digest the food in a very much matter sitting at home. Then you can also find there is an equilibrium and the harmony in your body. Self-healing takes place much more faster, removes the toxin. That is why when you inhale, you know, you inhale 5 liters of air inside, and while you exhale, you try to expel 400 ml, or you try to retain 750 to 1 liter of air in the body. So when you go with the pranayama, you know, the longer exhalation, you try to exhale complete toxic out and your body gets cleansed. So that is why the pranayama has been emphasized, and your breathing rate decreases, and the more it decreases, the longer your lifeline will be. So it enhances your power, and many more parasympathetic effects takes place in it. So you can just see the flexibility that is being increased. The researchers have spoken, it gives peace of mind, it increases your metabolic rate and reduces all that. Right. So when you look into the lazy people, you know, they'll ask somebody to press your feet, or wearing a chappal which has got some kind of pressure or cones on top, you know. So that is called as basically the lazy man's work. But if you, God has given you today, you are alive. We all are alive today. Why? Because God has got something that we need to perform. So let us utilize our time by keeping ourselves healthy, not to get affected by anything. and activate our nadis also. So doing the yogasana, it basically activates, and you can find the heart chakra, which is responsible for love and compassion, is being activated, and ananta flow, the blood flow goes, and you make people also happy at home and you get peace. So more benefits, you can see the stillness, the oxytocin, when it releases, you know, the inflammatory response lessens. This is where we go with COVID, and it is a thrombosis disease. The inflammation takes place in the body in any part, and the blood supply to the various organs gets seized. So when you go with it, you can definitely, your body will not react to COVID virus in a very bad manner. And it can also interact with the environment, and you don't get responded to the stress. There are more than 26 different techniques of pranayama, and you can perform at least four of that in a particular day, and you can get the benefit of it. So when you're sitting at home, you know, taking only deep fried puris, chapati, samosas, and all that can obviously affect the inner peace of your mind. And when you see the yogic diet speaks about the sadhavic diet, that is the food which is being prepared within 3 hours, you consume it, right? And there's no deep fry, no deep masalas, too much of oil, too much of salt in it, you know. Then you find your body is the your reflection of what you eat. Your aggression, your violence, your ability to shout, all that, you know, basically gets influenced because of your eating habits. So it was only those days that the people, Raja used to take the complete battalion with them for the war. And morning when they eat, you know, only at the sunset they were given, served second food. So those people were given with such a heavy food so that they'll be more aggressive, more violent, and try to face the war field in a better manner. So we people sitting at home during the lockdown period cannot every day go with such kind of food. So we need to change the diet that we need to take. And this is one of the best healthy food that we can look for and eat. Never try to grumble with the person who is cooking at home. Whatever is being served is absolutely fine. So Indian food, basically, when you look in it, it's high in carbohydrate, high in saturated fat. And in the urban scenario, this is the basically, you know, it is too high. So try avoiding the whites, that is white sugar, white salt, you know, and also the maida, which is white in color, may be avoided. You can go with more of fiber food, and complex sugar is much more better, which gives energy throughout the day and slow digestion takes place. And you can have a balanced diet, which speaks about your carbohydrate, protein, fat, milk products, and vitamins. And vitamins and minerals are playing a very vital role today. So whenever you take protein, is one essential that is being advised by doctors during this, particularly this pandemic situation, because it helps you to fight against corona in a much manner. But you ensure that protein is taken along with vitamin C. So there is always a combination of food which goes vitamin D with calcium with vitamin D, B complex with vitamin C. So if you just take only chapati or only bread or only rice, you know, empty, that will become zero calorie, and your body will not absorb that, and the proper hemoglobin, which is being formed along with carbohydrate and protein, that will not take place. So ensure that our food obviously is a staple food with carbohydrate. So carbohydrate is a good source of energy, can give you even empty calorie if you overeat it. Yeah. So you can substitute the food in different manner. Try to have the servings of vegetables, whichever is available in the market. Don't go for very expensive one. And now the supplements have become very essential. Try to sit in the sun every day from 11 o'clock to 2 o'clock. That is the most important time where the vitamin G is being absorbed by the body. And it is said that the white skin will absorb more vitamin D from the sun much more faster than the black skin. So we need to be more alert. If you find that, say, hair fall is there, or some sore in your mouth is there, you can just shift on to some multivitamin which replenishes or equates your deficiency of the vitamins. So always go with the sattvic food, such as whole grains, cereals, vegetables, legumes, nuts, seeds, honey, herbal, different types of herbal teas can be taken in wider. So you can avoid this rajasvic food as such, as I said, which will aggravate your anger. Even children will change, the mind changes. Even in the examination hall, you should not give them the rajasvic food and then send them for examination. So the food should be light, easily digestible. डकार नहीं आना चाहिए, burning नहीं होना चाहिए. जो खाना खाते हैं ना वो एकदम से पच जाना चाहिए, वैसा खाना खाइए. पर्टिकुलरली हमारा जो काम है वो सब कम हो गया है. और जब देखते हैं तो अभी सब लोग सिर्फ हॉट ड्रिंक्स पे बड़ा मजा लेते हैं. कहाँ कब ये खुलेगा, कब पियेंगे, अरे इसमें तो जीरो कैलोरी है, इसमें कुछ भी नहीं है, नो विटामिन, नो मिनरल, कुछ नहीं है. जस्ट वेस्टिंग योर मनी एंड द टाइम स्टैंडिंग इन द क्यू बाइंग इट. सो इस पैसों को आप किसी को दे सकते हैं या अपनी फैमिली की कुछ और बढ़ोतरी भी कर सकते हैं. तो योगा करने से क्या होगा, आपको मेंटल पीस मिलेगा. कुछ लोग से पूछा है हमने, इंटरव्यू किया है, आप क्यों पीते हैं, क्योंकि मेरा दिमाग खराब हो गया है, आई एम इन स्ट्रेस, मेरा आई डोंट हैव मेंटल पीस. सो क्या करते हैं, इनका मेंटल पीस गया तो औरों का मेंटल पीस भी चला जाता है. लेकिन ये सॉल्यूशन नहीं है. आप यू हैव टू स्टिक ऑन टू योगिक प्रैक्टिस और ये चीज़ों को छोड़ दीजिए. आज पहले तो वो वेस्टर्न कंट्रीज में था, आजकल इंडिया में इतना कॉमन हो गया है कि सभी लोग ऑलमोस्ट यू नो आज की जो जनरेशन है वो सब पीने लगे हैं. सो यू कैन अवॉइड डूइंग दैट. एंड थोड़ा सा ये जो आजकल का जो बोल रहे हैं जिंजर, गार्लिक, प्याज, ये सब थोड़ा सा ऐड कर लीजिए, सो दैट आपकी जो सहन शक्ति है, इम्यूनिटी पावर है, वो थोड़ा सा इंक्रीज हो जाएगा. जब भी आप खाना खाते हैं, अगर वद, पित्त और कबक कुछ भी अगर ज़्यादा हो जाता है ना, तो हमारा बॉडी का जो सिस्टम है वो ख़राब हो जाता है. तो आप ऐसा कीजिए, सब जो खाना खाते हैं वो सब सही होना चाहिए. कुछ भी लाइक मीठा आदि ज़्यादा खा लिया तो कोविड बहुत कोरोना वायरस को वो बहुत अच्छा लगता है. अगर नमक ज़्यादा हो गया तो हाइपरटेंशन हो जाता है. कुछ भी हो, अगर नमक तेल अधिक हो जाता है तो फिर पित्त अधिक हो जाता है. तो जो भी कुछ होता है ना, यू हैव टू हैव बैलेंस्ड फूड. मैंने जैसे बोला है, कुछ भी एक्स्ट्रा कैन ऑल्सो ऑलवेज एंड अप योर लाइफ. राइट, यू कैन सी अ पर्सन, ही इज कॉल्ड एज मिस्टर नेचुरल. एट 18 ईयर्स ही वॉज वेरी मच फाउंड ऑफ मेंटेनिंग हिज बॉडी एज अ फॉर्म ऑफ बॉडी बिल्डर. बट देन व्हेन ही बिकेम 50, यू कुड सी हिम बिकेम अ योगी एंड ही हैज गॉट हिज ओन इंस्टीट्यूशन इन Singapore and Malaysia also, and he is running institution and people are running after him. So when you see yogic asanas, you know, it has got different types of contraction, that is isotonic contraction, isometric is there, it touches upon your rib muscle fibers, you know, all the effects, you know, you could see, and even the oxygen supply to the working muscles also increases, and it keeps your mental peace. So when you see asana, basically Thiram Sukham Asanam. If I'm sitting on this chair, I must find comfortable. Any posture, whichever you take up, you must be in a balanced position and you must feel comfortable. So asanas can be performed with two type, with movement and without movement, slow and then and fast. So Surya Namaskara can be done with fast and slow or few asanas. And basically when you perform, you try to relax and concentrate your mind on it, right? So yogic concept, whenever you perform any asana, if you want to trigger upon say pancreas or liver or heart, try to know or where that organ is. Close your eyes while you perform your asanas. When attaining the posture, concentrate on that. So by performing yogasana, you can have your self-realization, which activates your channels, your nadis, your chakras, your kundalini shakti, and it gives peace and silence in you, and you feel the joy and reduce in the stress. So how should I do, what should I do, how, what is the right way of doing it? Whenever you do, you know, you need to have this five principle. Take a proper alignment of the posture, try to repeat that, and have a contrast, that is forward bending, backward bending, right side, left side, the self complementary asanas are there, all that could be performed. And Surya Namaskara is one which is a very complementary one, and it is on contrast basis, and you can get into the proximity, try to reach and have balance on particular posture. So when you see the asanas, you know, it touches upon the major muscles of the body. Don't think that the asanas are very cheap and very simple, and it is in vain that you are trying to perform. You could see the major muscles that have been activated, starting with your arm, your erector spinatus, the back muscle which keeps your back straight, your latissimus dorsi, your gluteus group of muscle, your hamstring group of muscle, your quadriceps group of muscle. All these muscles have been activated while you perform a simple warrior posture. So this is how you can get on. Even the small muscles also gets activated, like psoas is there, which you can find it. Then you can see the sternomastoid muscles of your neck gets activated. And any asana, you know, when you perform, try to peep into your body and feel the effect of it. And as we grow older, you know, the buttocks, basically the gluteus muscle starts sagging down. If you continue with your yogasana, you can keep that in shape, and then you will not get the other problems of sitting longer for in a particular posture, and all that are something associated with the old age. And you can perform Mahabandha, which is said to be Maha, means reaching the sigram, you know, the high level, where you can go with locking the Jalandhara, your Uddiyana, your stomach, and your Mula, your anus. When these are performed together at a stretch, you know, it is called as Mahabandha, and you can definitely perform sitting at home in front of even some TV channels. Right. So when you perform this Uddiyana Bandha, you can find the fats around your abdominal regions are being combusted, and how well you can develop your abdominal muscles, you see. Even Agnisar helps you to combust the fats around your abdomen, and the bulkiness in your stomach will go off, and you'll find your stomach in shape. And this is called a Sarvanga Asana. The Sarvanga Asana is said to be one of the best asana as long as the Indian yogic is concerned. If you perform this asana from 30 seconds to 1 minute every day, I know it replenishes your body completely, and you become more fine and getting equipped with all kind of deformities. So the biomechanically, when it is identified, you know, it is said that Parvatasana is one which takes the balance of your body on both the wrist. Your palm has got the equal weight. You have also got the feet, you know, which is having the balanced weight. You can touch upon your chakras. Your Kundalini Shakti is evoked. You can find your blood circulation to your brain, your eyes, your face, and the muscles are also being activated. So it gives you stability. It protects small joints. It gives flexibility, and many more importance are there. So when you see this particular asana, it gives you, you know, the enormous stability, perfection. Again, the small joints are being protected very well, right? So science has proved, you know, what are the asanas that get into your body and how you need to perform. When you see this chakrasana, again, it gives a balance, equal weight on all the legs need to be performed, and you will not get any side effects or injuries on it. Even you can perform with the props. You can make use of your pillows, your other chair or whatever, you know, improvised thing can be used to support the people, and even you can support and perform the asana and get the benefits. And you can see the some of the asana with the posture, you can improve your backache, your spinal problems, everything can be pushed off. Even Dharmurasana can be done for backache people. You can keep your body fine, even the facial muscles. You become young by performing Dharmurasana. So if still you want to practice, you can start with a standing asana to sitting asana at a stretch, and it can be called as power yoga. And when you do pranayama, you know, basically it relates with your emotions, and pranayama increases your breathing volume. It reduces your breathing rate, right? That is where we speak about the resting pulse rate. So pranayama can help you, and it slows the breath rate. The slower your breath rate, the longer your lifespan is. When you compare that with, you know, the mouse takes 120 times and the lifespan is 3, pigeon goes for 30 times in a minute and the lifespan is 8. In this form, the turtle takes 4 breaths a minute and it has got 250 years. An elephant takes 12 times and it lives for 120 years. So average human being, when you say they take 15 to 18 times, they breathe, and their lifespan from 60 to 80 years, it goes on with. So when you perform, you know, the left side and the right side, even in anatomy, kinesiology, you can see the right side, left side. In the same manner, it has been related with the Iddha Nadi and the Pingala Nadi. So Iddha means Chandra. It gives you coolness. It has got the right side. It leads you to the subconsciousness, and it leads to your control of emotions. Your intuition power increases, your devotion, your rest, and your quality of the life improves. When you go with the see the right side, the Pingala Nadi, which speaks with the Surya, the warmness it gives. The left side gets affected, that is the opposite side, and the consciousness increases. Your thought gets provoked and you can have a positive thought, your intellectual ability increases, and of course it leads to quantitative life. So when you perform pranayama, you can activate your right side and the left side of the brain. Even if you go with the abacus and even with the physical exercises asana, you use the right side and the left side of the brain. So that is a hand, so right, both the hands when you use, you know, it influences your right side of the brain and the left side of the brain. So that is why exercises and doing asanas are one of the best way that you can develop peace, joy, happy, compassion. Egoless perfection can be attained. And when you look at your breathing aspect, you know, you can improve upon so many things. Your respiratory rate, your heart attack can be pushed off. You can control your emotions. You can increase your metabolic rate, your strength of the body, your weakness of the mind. You can rejuvenate yourself. So this is the ratio of breathing, where 2:1 is to 2:1, which improves your respiratory rate. So you have to perform inhale, then retention, Bahari Kumbhaka, Andhri Kumbhaka, then exhale, and then Bahari Kumbhaka. So these are the four phases that you can go with it. And Rechva and the Purukha, which comes here. And when you look at the human lungs, you know, if when you spread the lungs, it will even spread one tennis court. It is such a big, basically. So an adult lung, lungs are such a vast. When you inhale and exhale, you can definitely take 5 liters of air inside, and you can expel complete 5 liters. It's not possible, but you can at least expel 4.750 ml of liter of air can be expelled, and this is called as residual volume. So while you perform your pranayama, you can definitely improve your residual volume. So when you see the lungs and the heart, basically the human heart pumps about 70 ml of blood per beat of the heart. So 72 beats, you know, which leads to then 5 liters of blood is pumped per minute, and about 7,200 liters of blood is pumped per day. So this adds up to 26,28,000 liters of blood per year. So just imagine when you reach 70 years, you know, what is your lifespan and how much of blood is being pumped. So try to perform these pranayama yogic practice will definitely help you. And this is one of the sayings said by the John, he's a big musician. So when he was went to the school when he was 5 years, you know, he said, my mother always told me that happiness was the key to life. When I went to school, my teacher asked me, what would you do after growing up? So he said, I want to be happy. So teacher said that this child has not understood the assignment. Basically, the teacher did not understand the life. So ultimately, if you are happy, your life is happy, that means you have won the and conquered what all the life that you have come across. So get better through yoga, do yoga even more than that, do yoga when don't want to do yoga when you do yoga when you have time, and do yoga when you don't. So every day yoga is must. Keep it as a form of your routine. Keep performing yoga as part of your life and every day, and also encourage the people in your house. So believe anything is possible. The only reason the bubble bees can fly is because no one told them her that you can't fly. So even the ants carry 3 times of their weight on top of them and they go. But why? Because nobody said to them that you can't do. So everybody can do. It is possible. And keep doing yoga. Let me wish you all once again a very happy International Day. Thank you so much. I know I went like a marathon. Unmute Sangeeta. No.
Thanks, Dr. Jyoti Madam, for your inspiring presentation. Your years of research and your depth of knowledge of the subject and ability to represent in such an interesting way is really admirable. Thanks a lot for sharing your knowledge with us. Now I am going to call Dr. Samina Qureshi, Professor of Chemistry, Government Girls PG College, Ujjain, to introduce our distinguished speaker, Dr. Kokab Azim. Over to you, Samina madam.
Thank you, Sangeeta madam. It's my pleasure to welcome next speaker for today's session, Proficient Dr. Kokab Azim, Assistant Professor, Department of Physical Education, King Fahd University of Petroleum and Minerals, Saudi Arabia. He is also the President of International Federation of Fitness, Health, Physical Education and Iron Games and Vice President of World Strength Lifting Federation. Dr. Azim received his PhD from Usmania University, Hyderabad, India. His research work has a focus on strength training, physical activity, aerobics, health and performance, obesity and changes in body composition. He has won gold medal in the International Strength Lifting Championship at Kingdom of Bahrain in 2015. He has been renowned with awards such as Best Teacher Award at King Fahd University of Petroleum and Minerals, Best Research Paper Award at International Conference on Sports Medicine and Fitness in Chicago, USA. Excellent services to the development of sports science by the directors of Board of International Science, Culture and Sport Association in Turkey. Highest international award for the contribution in physical education and sports scientists from IFPEFSSA. Dr. Kokab's more than 90 research papers have been published in the various international journals and international conference proceedings. He is the author of 2 books also. He is also supervisor for MPhil and PhD program. He delivered more than 50 lectures as invited speaker and about 32 presentations in international conferences. Dr. Kokab is a member of editorial boards of 25 international journals, guest editor in American Journal of Sports Science, USA, scientific advisor for Foundation for Global Community Health, USA, visiting professor, Ministry of Education and Culture, Faculty of Sports Science, Indonesia for the year 2020-21. Today, Dr. Kokab Azim will share with us his thought on the topic Pranayam, a breath to life. I request, sir, to please begin. Over to you, sir.
Thank you, madam. Assalamu alaikum. Namaste. Good afternoon, everybody. Respected chief guest of today's international conference, Dr. Devashish Ji, the Director and Head Department of Physical Education and Sports Management at Goa, India. Eminent invited speaker, Dr. K. Jyoti from YMCA College of Physical Education and from Chennai. Dr. Anita, Madam, Principal and Patron of this STEAM conference, Mrs. Sangeeta, webinar convener and sports officer, Dr. Neeta Tapan, the coordinator of this STEAM conference, and Dr. Samina Qureshi, madam. She is the chair of this session. Dear delegates and friends, I take an immense pleasure to be part of this STEAM conference. And I like to congratulate everybody on the day, wonderful day of yoga. As we know, and just now madam has given a very vast presentation, and he has given insight of yoga and yoga in India, especially we are having a very rich history of yoga. And now we had given this yoga as a gift to all the world, and in many countries when I have been fortunate to travel to US or Australia or Europe, I have seen a lot of yoga centers there, and they are practicing yoga. And yoga is a life, and it is really important for one and all, and it should be part of our life. So let me share the presentation for today. Share screen. Window open. Can you view my slide, madam?
Yes, sir. It's visible.
Okay, now I'm going to the second. It is change. Hope you are seeing the second slide now.
Yes, sir.
It's visible. Yes. Okay.
Visible, sir.
So breathing. Breathing is very important. Breathing may be considered the most important of all the functions of the body, for indeed all the other functions depends upon it. Introduction to breathing. Life and breath are intimately connected. As per the yogic principles, life is period between one breath to the next. A person who only half breathing has only half life. Though our whole life entirely depends on breathing, we give rare attention on its process. Dear friends, when we go in the flights or when we go in any dark places sometimes, maybe if you go sometimes in the ground floor, especially in the, you will feel suffocation and people will faint, people will get problems due to this breathing. So breathing is very important part of our life. If breathing is a spontaneous function of the body, then why should we care? Our respiratory muscles become lazy and cease to give optimum inhalation and exhalation. Modern life factors which influence the breathing: not having cold shower, no natural environmental living, air conditions work style, like we have split or central AC system. For example, you are not exposed to split system, you will get the sinus problems, maybe you get a cold. But central AC system is, you know, we can manage our house equal temperature in all our villas or all our houses. Lifestyle modification. Non-harmonious thinking pattern, you have to think positively, very strong mind. And pollution is not only in India but across the world, it is a big challenge. So you have to exercise in a very hygienic place, polluted place. You should not practice near the pollution, which in the, and especially on the roadsides. I give this instructions to my students and as well as for our family members and friends. No balanced diet. For example, students, they don't care sometimes because, you know, they just want to eat a tasty food, not mom food, not from the kitchen, from the mom foods. They want to take from the restaurants. And especially when I talk to my students, I take their, background, what, from where they are eating. So always they say, I go to this restaurant, I go to that restaurant. Then I give them my suggestions. Dear friends, no, don't do that. Okay, in a month, yes, you can go and enjoy your foods, but always you should have a hygienic foods. You should take a balanced diet. All madam has given a lot of insight about the Dr. Jyoti madam, already she has given a lot of insight about the foods. So what is a balanced diet? What are the nutrients of balanced diet? Protein, carbohydrates, fats, vitamins, and water, minerals. This all combined together, we will say a balanced diet. Balanced diet, it should be in a proper proportion. For like bodybuilders or wrestlers, they used to take a lot of fatty foods. In the old age, they get problems. So they have to clean themselves. They have to reduce their body fat, which is very important. And for bodybuilders also, they take a lot of protein diet. And they don't know the what is the adverse effect of that on the human body. They have to see the health also. When you're doing your sport, you have to see your health, because we can buy anything in the world. Can you buy your health? No. So performance is there. Yes, I agree. But you have to see your health also. So protein, how much they have to take. If you're not taking in the proper proportion, then definitely it will affect on your kidneys. And we have to take in what proportion we have to take. Protein diet, you are taking from the vegetarian, like soya bean we have, or you are taking from the non-vegetarian and vegetarian sources. So which is suitable for your body? How much protein is suitable for you? Like, for example, you are taking one gram of protein. You are digesting or not? It is suitable for your body or not? So sometimes trainers and coaches, they say, no problem. Take 300 grams of protein. This is not good. Not good for the health. So advise in a right way. Sensible approach. And you have to take green vegetables. You have to take 4 fruits with different colors. You have to take plenty of water, plenty of fruits with different colors and vegetables. And you can take some complex carbohydrate. So in this case, you can have you can take all in your diet, like balanced diet. But and according to the vitamin D in some European and some of in India, sometimes in winter, you don't get, because always you are inside, you don't get vitamin D. So expose yourself, tan yourself 10 minutes, 15 minutes, and early morning is very important. The sun rays are important. So that you will get a natural vitamin D, because many women, they get the vitamin D deficiencies. Different methods of breathing per yogic principle. There are 3 stages of breathing process: abdominal or diaphragmatic breathing, intercostal or middle breathing, clavicular or upper breathing. Abdominal or diaphragmatic breathing. Breathing is associated with the movement of diaphragm and other wall of abdomen. Normally, when relaxed or exhale position, diaphragm muscles arches upward towards the chest. During the inhalation, the diaphragm muscle starts moving upwards, which compresses the abdominal organs and eventually pushes the front wall, the belly of the abdominal, outwards. This movement enlarges the chest cavity downwards, allowing lungs to expand and thereby air drawn to lungs from surroundings. Again, on relaxation or exhalation, the diaphragm muscles pulled upwards to reduce the volume in the chest cavity and thereby causing exhalation. And as we know that, everybody knows what is inhalation and exhalation, but I will just demonstrate you how you will inhale, how you will exhale. So complete and thoroughly you have to do, and without jerking movement. This form of breathing draws in maximum amount of air with least muscular effects. This type of breathing is associated with movement of the ribcage. During the expansion of ribcage, the lungs are allowed to expand. Air being drawn into the lungs from the front side, when the rib outer muscles get relaxed, the ribs move downwards and inwards and compresses the lungs, and exhalation takes place. Clavicular or upper breathing. This type of breathing is associated with the movement of the shoulder and collarbone. For this is our shoulder and this is our clavicular, or we can say collarbone. And these efforts needs much effort, little inhalation and exhalation. This movement will have no direct influence of any lungs oxygen exchanges. Yogic breathing is nothing but combination of all the previous mode of 3 breathings, abdominal, middle, and upper, into one harmonious movement. This is the best breathing method to optimize our lungs capacity, because It's involvement of total. We can say a basic movement. This type of breathing that we need to develop before any breathing techniques or pranayama. Yogic practices for healthy living. In the present time, more and more people are resorting to yoga to find cure for chronic health problems and attain a peace of mind. Through medication and pranayama, one can banish all the stress and lead a healthy lifestyle. Dear friends, as we know, stress is the biggest killer in the world. We have day-to-day life, we have stress, we have occupation, our work stress, we have social stress, we have family stress, financial stress, or transportation stress. We have different type of stress on our human body. So always you have to cope up the stress in a nice way, dealt like a professional, smiling face, and be strong with your mind. Why Tendulkar is a outstanding player and one of the best batsmen in the world? Because he cope up the stress in a nice way. When Australians, they give him hard time, they instigate him, they abuse him, he just give answer with his smile. That smile we have to learn from him. If you learn that smile and don't take stress on yourself, believe me, you will never get any problems. You have to be very, very strong from your mind and don't take on your heart. In fact, it is one of the best remedies known to humankind for curing chronic ailments that are otherwise difficult to be cured by other medications. If you're taking medicines also, if you are in a high stress, nobody can change you. Doctor cannot help you unless from inside, if you have that challenge to come out and strong will, you cannot, medication can also cannot help you. Pranayama are the best exercises to increase the lung capacity. Yoga may play a significant role in psychosocial care and rehabilitation of COVID-19 patients in quarantine and isolations. They are particularly useful in allaying their fears and anxiety. As we know that these two things, fears and anxiety, is very, very high among the people who got the COVID or they don't get the COVID. So both the people, population, everybody, including myself, I was having anxiety. Okay, today I'm going outside. I don't know what's going to happen. But once we come back, we know that we have to wash our hands, walk our legs, walk our clothes, everything. This anxiety and fear, not only for me, for everybody in the society, everywhere in the world, everybody in the globe, they are having fears and anxiety. But this fear and anxiety can be controlled by yoga. If you do yoga and maybe you do some type of medications, and definitely you can come out and you can keep yourself more strong. Yoga for respiratory systems and COVID-19 affects the respiratory system. Asanas promote and maintain elasticity of the ribcage and intercostal muscles. Asanas help to strengthen the diaphragm. The lung gets strengthened through standing poses. One thing is very important when you do this exercise also, neuromuscular coordination. What exercise you are doing, you have to feel it. I'm telling you, because I was a bodybuilder, I was a strength lifter. When we teach, the first principle we teach to my students is neuromuscular coordination. Don't just do like a copy machine. Feel it. Unless you feel it, you cannot improve yourself. This is what the insight I'm giving to you. This is called professional touch. For example, I'm doing bench press. For example, I'm telling you, if I'm not connecting with my brain, you will never improve your pectoral muscle. Asanas helps to strengthen the diaphragm. The lung gets strengthened through standing poses. The lungs get toughened by inverted poses. A person gets trained to breathe in restricted cavity through forward bending asanas. backbending asanas strengthen the circulation in entire lower respiratory tract. Asanas tone up the cartilages and helps to remain soft and elastic. I take only 1 second to water because outside it is 47. It's very hot here. Pranayama is what heart is to the human body. Light on the Yoga Sutras of Patanjali. Pranayama are specially developed breathing techniques, improves brain function, intelligence and memory, increasing the elimination of toxins from the system. The total effect of yoga asanas and breathing is to produce a state of high vitality and rejuvenation. Studies have shown that increase in the serotonin level in the brain with regular pranayama. These are the earlier studies. If you will go through, you will find this significant results. The hemoglobin and oxygen saturation is enhanced during kamboka as there is more time for saturation. Due to pranayama, practices better diffusion of gases and gases occurs. The vital capacity and inspiratory reserve volume are increased. The dead space into the lung is reduced. The residual volume is decreased. Pranayama practice helps in excretion of toxins and gases. Maintenance of physical health is enhanced due to efficient changes in blood gases. The ventilation of sinuses is enhanced, promoting proper drainage. Suggested yogic practices to improve immunity and respiratory system for children under 8 to 12. Losing exercises, children's Surya Namaskar, Chandra Namaskar, dynamic basic asanas, warrior poses, pranayama, chanting mantras, yoga nidra. Adolescents, youth and middle age, this for healthy people, and they can do Surya Namaskar and others, and Pranayama, Kapalabhati, sectional breathing, Ujjayi, Bhastrika, Nadi Sudhi, meditation, losing exercises, and Savasana. Geriatric community, speciality that focuses on health care of elderly people. This is very, very important. Losing exercises, Tadasana and others, Savasana, Pranayama, Ujjayi, Nadi Sudhi, and meditation. This all are very important for elderly people. Kapalabhati improves pulmonary functions and reduces secretions. Very useful preparatory practice for Pranayama. Helps to cleanse frontal sinuses. Kapalabhati pranayama, frontal brain cleansing breathe. Sit in a comfortable meditation asana. The head and spine should be straight with the head resting on the knees in either chin or jnana mudra. Close the eyes and relax the whole body, which is very important. Exhale through both nostrils with a forceful contraction of the abdominal muscles. The following inhalation should take place passively by allowing the abdominal muscles to relax. Inhalation should be spontaneous recoil. After completing 10 rapid breaths in succession, inhale and exhale deeply. For example, 10 times you are doing, that is called 10 repetitions. If you have complete the 10 repetitions, that is called one set. Allow the breath to return to normal. This is called one round. Kapalabhati, to clean excess mucus from the nasal passages, Kapalabhati should be practiced before pranayama. That is, it's a basic foundation. So go to the next level. Kapalabhati should be performed on an empty stomach. Better. It will have any more effect, more significant results. 3 to 4 hours or you can do after the 3 to 4 hours of after your meals. If practiced late night, it can prevent sleep. So be careful. And if pain or dizziness is experienced, you have to stop the practice immediately. Kapalabhati should not be practiced by those suffering from heart disease, night blood pressure, vertigo, epilepsy, stroke, hernia, or gastric ulcers. So these people with certain medical conditions, they should not practice this. And it is not recommended during pregnancy for the women. Seasonal breathing, this is a preparatory breathing practice for pranayama. It corrects the wrong breathing pattern and increases the vital capacity of the lungs. It has 3 sections. Let us see what is that. Place the hands resting on the thighs in Sin Mudra. Inhale deeply, slowly and continuously. Abdomen bulges out. Before exhaling, stop the breath for a few seconds effortlessly. Exhale, the abdomen is drawn inwards continuously and slowly, because it should be always, the execution should be proper and it should be done correctly, sensibly. Before the breath is reversed, stop the breath for a second. Repeat this breathing cycle for 5 times. There should be no jerks in the whole process. It should be smooth, continuous and relaxing. And enjoy your exercise. Always, whenever you are doing any exercise, enjoy. And when you are giving to the students, involved with some music or involved with some fun, so to attract the students more to our exercises. Thoracic intercostal breathing. Place the hands resting on the thighs in Sinmaya Mudra. While inhaling, expand the chest cage forwards, outwards and upwards. While exhaling, relax the chest wall and return to the resting position. Repeat this breathing cycle 4 or 5 times. Sit in any meditative posture. Place the hands resting on the thighs in Adi Mudra. While inhaling, raise the collarbone and shoulders upward and backward. You have to raise your shoulders until it touches your ears. Keep it forward and backward. Keep forward and backward. So you can do this one, and also you can do like up and down. That's, you can do the shrugs also, you can do it. And while exhaling, drop down the shoulders to the resting position. Repeat this breathing cycle 4 or 5 times. Full yogic breathing is a combination of all the 3 sections, sectional breathing, and you can practice this way. Place the hands resting on the abdomen at level in Brahma Mudra. During inhalation, the Adhama, Madhyama, and Adhya Pranayama occurs sequentially. Now exhale in the same method of practice, abdominal, chest, and clavicular. Repeat this breathing cycle 4 or 5 times. Sit in a comfortable meditation posture with head and spine upright, eyes closed. Adopt Nasagara Mudra with the right hand and place the left hand on the knee in Chin or Dhyana Mudra. Close the right nostril with the thumb. Inhale and exhale through the left nostril 5 times. After completing 5 breaths, press the left nostril with the ring finger, blocking the right nostril 5 times. Keeping the respiration rate normal. Lower the hand and breathe 5 times through the nostrils together. Practice 5 rounds or for 3 to 5 minutes. Contraindications. Nadi Shodhana is not to be practiced while suffering from colds, flu or fever. Practice. Sit in any comfortable meditation asana with eyes closed. Feel or imagine that the breath is being drawn in and out through the throat and not through the nostrils. When, as the breathing becomes slower and deeper, gently contract the glottis so that a soft snoring sound like the breathing of a sleeping baby is produced in the throat. Interesting. Both inhalation and exhalation should be long, deep, and controlled. Begin with 10 breaths and slowly increase to 5 minutes for general benefits. People who are too introverted by nature should not perform these practices. Stop thinking what could go wrong and start thinking what you could right. Always think positively. Life is here to enjoy it and no one has the right to suffer. Maharishi Mahesh Yogiji. Whatever you do in life, yoga shows you how to do it better. Thank you very much for giving me an opportunity to attend this wonderful seminar, international conference on yoga, on Yoga Day, important day. I'd like to thank again Mrs. Sangeeta Madamji for inviting me. Thank you, one and all. Thank you very much. Over to Mrs. Sangeeta Madam.
Thank you, sir. We are grateful for the time and effort you took to share your thoughts and experiences with us. I am sure we all will be benefited from the methods you have suggested. Thanks a lot, sir, for your valuable contribution. Thank you once again. Now it's time for the presidential address. I am going to invite Dr. Anita Manchandia, Principal, Government Girls PG College, Ujjain, a dynamic personality filled with enthusiasm. She always motivates us for such a great events. With due respect, I invite you, Madam, Dr. Anita Madam, over to you.
Thank you, Sangeeta Madam. Thank you very much. Good evening to all our guests and participants of this international webinar on International Yoga Day, Yoga for Well-Being, organized by Department of Physical Education and Internal Quality Assurance Cell of Government Girls PG College, Ujjain. First of all, I would like to express my gratitude to our honorable guest, Dr. Devashish Bagchi from Goa, and our invited speakers, Dr. K. Jyoti from Chennai and Dr. Kokub Azim from Saudi Arabia, for sharing their knowledge, information, and most important is their valuable time with us. Thank you very much, sir. As we know, yoga is a physical, mental, and spiritual practice which is originated in India. Our Prime Minister, Sri Narendra Modi ji, in his UN address in 2014, has suggested the date of 21st of June, as it is the longest day of the year in the Northern Hemisphere and shows a special significance in many parts of the world. And the celebration of International Yoga Day is started from 21st June 2015. Human beings are made up of mainly three elements, which are the mind, body, and soul. Similarly, in order to satisfy the needs of these three, we need knowledge, health, and inner peace respectively. As we know, health is a physical need, whereas knowledge is a psychological need of ours. when we take about, we talk about inner peace, we see it refers to the spiritual need, and we feel harmonious only when these three are present. Only art of practicing yoga can help in controlling an individual mind, body and soul. It brings together physical and mental disciplines to achieve a peaceful body and mind. It helps to manage stress and anxiety and keeps us relaxing. During this COVID time, as we know, hum jaan rahe hain ki bahut zyada sabhi, chahe wo chote bacche ho, buzurg ho, ghar ke, sabhi bahut adhik tanav mein hain, bahut stress hai. वीकनेस कईयों को आ चुकी है. कोविड से जो सफर करके बाहर आए हैं वो डेढ़ डेढ़ दो दो महीने बाद भी अभी तक अपने आप को फिट नहीं पा रहे हैं. इस पैंडेमिक सिचुएशन में इस प्रकार के वेबिनार्स ऑर्गेनाइज करने का मेन मकसद हमारा यही रहता है कि सब तक, हर व्यक्ति तक हम उस अभियान को पहुंचा सकें या उन्हें जागरूक कर सकें कि वे किस प्रकार से अपने आप को फिट रख सकते हैं. और हम ये देख भी रहे हैं कि जैसे अभी हमारे एक्सपर्ट्स ने हमें बताया, काफी सारी चीजों के बारे में उन्होंने बताया. सबसे इम्पोर्टेंट चीज जो बताई है कि यदि हम रोज नियम से योगा प्राणायाम, प्राणायाम में हम सारी ब्रीदिंग एक्सरसाइज जैसे सर ने बताई हमें, प्राणायाम की सारी विधि जो है, भस्त्रिका आसन है, कपाल भारती है, अनुलोम विलोम है, ये सब करें, और अपनी डाइट को यदि नियमित रख के एक बैलेंस डाइट का चार्ट बनाकर यदि हम लेते हैं, हेल्दी न्यूट्रिशियस डाइट हो हमें हमारे लिए, तो ही हम इस सब चीजों से बहुत जल्द अपने आप को बाहर ला सकते हैं. निश्चित रूप से सारे प्राणायाम की कई टेक्निक्स हमें सर ने बताई हैं, प्राणायाम की टेक्निक बताई, आसन की टेक्निक बताई, वो सब यदि हम स्ट्रिक्टली फॉलो करते हैं तो निश्चित रूप से इस पैंडेमिक सिचुएशन में भी हम अपने आप को हेल्दी और फिट रख सकते हैं. इसीलिए मैं मेरे सारे पार्टिसिपेंट्स आज वेबिनार में जितने भी जुड़े हैं, मैं उन सब से आग्रह निवेदन भी करना चाहती हूँ कि जो जो बारीकियां सर ने बताई हैं, हम काफी सारे आसन करते हैं, प्राणायाम भी करते हैं, पर उन बारीकियों को नहीं समझ पाते कि जो असल में इसमें होना चाहिए. हम एक लेमैन की तरह थोड़ा बहुत टीवी में देखा उसको किस प्रकार करना है और वैसे ही शुरू कर देते हैं. तो एक एक्सपर्ट के गाइडेंस में, या जैसे अभी हमने, हमें सर मैडम ने, ज्योति मैडम ने, आजिम सर ने बताया है, उन सब टेक्निक्स को फॉलो करते हुए बहुत ध्यान से, यदि अपनी हेल्थ का ध्यान रखते हुए वो सारी योगा एक्सरसाइज आसन जितने भी सर ने बताया, ब्रीदिंग एक्सरसाइज यदि हम करते हैं तो निश्चित रूप से हम अपने आप को हेल्दी रख सकते हैं. बस मैं बहुत ज्यादा नहीं कहना चाहूंगी, समय बहुत हो चुका है, इसीलिए सभी से निवेदन है, स्टे सेफ, स्टे हेल्दी और वैक्सीनेशन जरूर कराएं. जितने भी पार्टिसिपेंट जुड़े हैं उन सब से एक बार पुनः अनुरोध है कि अपने परिवार में, अपने आसपास सभी का वैक्सीनेशन जरूर करवाएं. वैक्सीनेशन से कम हम उस क्रिटिकल कंडीशन तक न पहुंचे, न अपने अड़ोसी पड़ोसी या अपने समाज के किसी व्यक्ति को पहुंचने दें कि वो हमसे ही बिछड़ जाए. इसीलिए सभी को प्रेरित करें, स्वयं भी वैक्सीनेशन कराएं और अड़ोस पड़ोस में भी, पूरे समाज में अपने साथियों को प्रेरित करें वैक्सीनेशन कराने के लिए. स्टे सेफ, स्टे हेल्दी. थैंक यू संगीता मैडम, एंड थैंक्स अगेन आवर गेस्ट एंड ऑनरेबल गेस्ट एंड आवर स्पीकर्स. थैंक यू वेरी मच.
थैंक यू मैडम, थैंक यू फॉर योर एड्रेस. Now time for vote of thanks. As a convener of this webinar, I am expressing my views. It is such an honor for me to get the opportunity to thank you all dignitaries on behalf of the entire institution. I would like to express my gratitude to all the delegates for their presence and contribution to make this webinar a great success. I extend my thanks to Honorable Chief Guest Dr. Devashish Bakshi to take out time from his busy schedule to grace this event. I am thankful to both the resource person, Dr. K. Jyoti Madam and Dr. Kokab Azim Sir, who accepted my invitation in a very short time, your presence glorify this webinar. A special thanks to Dr. Anita Manchandia, Principal Government College, Ujjain, for providing immense support to make this webinar successful. I thanks Dr. Neeta Tappan Madam, IQAC Coordinator, for her sincere efforts to make this webinar successful. I must thanks Dr. Hemant Gehlot Sir for his support to make this webinar successful. He has given a wonderful speech, praised by everyone. Thank you, sir. I am thankful from the core of my heart to Dr. Nancy Chauhan Madam and Dr. Samina Qureshi Madam for helping me in introducing our speakers. I am thankful to Dr. Dharmesh Sir for his technical support to make this program a grand success. Thank you one and all. I thanks each and everyone directly who helped me directly or indirectly for making this event successful. Thank you one and all. Stay safe, stay at home. Thank you.